guys, it's AnnesAnimals here, and I am back finally after so long of just planning and working at school and all those things. I was super busy. I'm so sorry for the complete year without any uploads, but right now I'm trying to like catch up, and I'll try and, you know, get some videos out. But anyways, today I will be showing you how to make a cozy box. So this one will be the first one out of, I think, six or seven cozy themed things I am planning on making, and this is probably the easiest one to make. So first of all, what you'll need to do is cut these squares out of cardboard, and I will put the dimensions on the screen. These will be the inside of your box, since it will need some structure, so this will provide it with structure. You can choose to not make it without this, but I chose to do this since it will hold up better. Anyways, what you will need is either a single fleece fabric to do both layers with, or you can do what I did and do one layer, one color on the outside and one color on the inside. This is for me old mattress cover, and I do not recommend doing it with this because it's very hard to cut, very hard, I repeat, and it will hurt your hands. So I recommend that you actually go out and get some fleece, which is way easier to cut. So for these things, you will have to cut a half inch bigger for these squares, only a half an inch bigger. I will show the dimensions on the screen for that one too. And this is all you need, except if you have a sewing machine, you also need that, or you can do it by hand. It's a little longer and harder to do it by hand, but it's doable. I will not be doing it by hand, which I usually do, but I will be doing it with the sewing machine. And this is pretty much all you need for materials, and I'll be showing you how to do it by machine. And you can do it similarly by hand, but it depends on what you want to do. So yeah. So what I recommend starting with is actually the first square with the circle in it, because it's the most tedious to do, because, you know, the circle's there. So what I will be showing you how to do this, except it won't be step by step, because I don't want this video to be too long, because I know some people do not like watching videos that are really long. So what I will give you is a little rundown on what you have to do. What you will start with is by, what you will do first is actually sew along this line, along the circle, which will give you, it has to be right side, I forgot to say this, it has to be right side facing right side, so this side is facing the clean side. So you will have to sew along here, and that will give you a little seam that will be like this. And I will show you afterwards what you have to do. So now, what you're left with is this, like I said earlier. And what you want to do is actually pass this through, but do not pass it completely inside out. You have to keep the edge here, the edge, from actually going through all the way. So what you want to do is actually do I'm just going to show it since it's hard to explain. So once you have all of this fabric out, I forgot my pins, but you'll have to pin it outside like this. You see, it gives you a clean seam like this. So once you have that, you pin it on the outside like this. And your cardboard piece will go inside of here, but I will show you how to do this afterwards. Now I will show you how to pass the cardboard piece through, or like onto this new piece you have. So I unfortunately made a mistake and thought you had to cut a slit into the hole, I guess. So you don't have to do that. I figured that out. So if you accidentally do that, just glue it together and it should be good. So what you do to put it in is that you just slide this piece of fabric through here. And that will allow you to have a piece that is sturdy between both layers. And since you cut your piece bigger on this side, it will leave you some space to actually sew this together. So this is why I cut it half an inch bigger, so I would have a lot of leeway to actually sew this. So I will come back once it is sewn. Do not trim the sides yet, because we will need them to attach this panel to the other panels. But now that I showed you how to do the front panel, I will show you how to do one of these sides, because since on this pattern, or on this model, the sides are all the same. They're all the same dimensions because it's a cube. So I'll show you how to make one of the sides, and then I will just speed through the rest, and yeah, I'll show you the end product too. While trying to show you how to make a side and back panel, you know, the basic panel, I ran into an issue and I didn't realize that you don't actually have to sew the whole thing closed. So what you actually have to do is leave a space open to put the piece in, and I didn't think about that, sorry. So I'll show you the actual what finished product of this panel will be after I fix what I did. So yeah, I'll be back. I am back after fixing my problem. So what I actually wanted to show you how to make a panel, like what you have to do actually is you take one of these pieces and you put it right side with this piece, and what you do, you sew along here, here, and here, but you leave one space here open so you can actually put this in. So after you sew this around, you flip this inside out, and this is what I have here. So what I'm gonna do, I'm just gonna slide this in. And after this, I will sew the edge here. And you can either leave it rough like this, since this seam will be hidden either way, or you can go the extra mile and actually fold and sew this. But I don't have that much space left, so I'm going to just sew here, and I will put a time lapse of every panel being sewn. And once I have every panel, I will show you how to attach them.
Thank you.
what you want to do is actually combine them right side on right side. So you can either have green side on green side, which leaves you with a clean seam on the outside, or you can do white side on white side, which leaves you a neat seam on the inside. So I will insert a clip here. If you decide to do green on green and you have a chewer, like my gerbils are big chewers, any gerbil I think is just a big chewer, but if you decide to do green on green and have the clean seam on the outside and the seam on the inside, they will most likely destroy it within 2 days, a day, depending. But by having the clean seam or no seam on the inside, it's less likely that they'll break it immediately and they won't get to the seam very easily, so it might last longer. So when you want to combine these two pieces, what you do is that you put white on white or green on green, depending on what you're doing, and you sew along the side like here. You would sew along here, and then that will leave you with a seam like this. And if you're doing on this piece, you're doing the same thing. You sew along the edge, not in the cardboard. Make sure you don't do it in the cardboard. You don't sew in the cardboard, and it will leave you with a seam like this. And once you have this piece sewn, to combine this piece to these, so you just put white on white, you sew along, and you have the piece connected. So I hope this is clear enough. It's hard to explain, but I think you all are really smart and you'll be able to figure it out. So yeah. Well, once you have this finished product of once you sew these sides together, these ones, and I think this one too, you'll be left with a few sides that that still need to be sewn. So you can either use your machine and try to sew those sides, and it's a little hard. I haven't tried it personally, but what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna sew this by hand. And once that's all done, there you go. That's the finished product. It's not the neatest. It's not the neatest finished product, but at least it will last a bit longer since the seams are inside. You can always do the opposite and do the seams could also be on the inside if you choose to. And that will give you a neater outside finished product and the seams will be on the inside. So you risk having it get destroyed really easily and quickly. So if you enjoyed this video, leave a like, that would be really appreciated. And if you're new, subscribe.